GP40-2s, and a very nice looking train of ethanol, dead loads, and empty rock brought us over to the Dixie flyover for FEC train 109, Jacksonville to Miami with a Fort Lauderdale set out. From this point on, it was back to the Deerfield Beach Tri-Rail Station for some more commuter and passenger live action, and also the hopes of catching 0717 to Sun Sentinel Switcher. While the Switcher would never make it to the station, we would still be treated to a pretty good medley of Amtrak and Tri-Rail trains, including 92 with Patty Holmes.
Quiet. trip.
Yeah, it's Tuesday. Is that Cannon?
Kate Cannon. I think this is a 4:30.
They're paying, but they work pretty good.
No, this is a 3:2 actually.
What?
I don't know. Shave and a haircut.
It was back to the Dixie Flyover on the Florida East Coast mainland for another special catch. Train 202 putting on quite a show for all of the rail fans here at Deerfield Beach. See video of my catch of the office car special here in the link that is going to appear right on the screen. racing to drop off Anthony at his home in Hialeah, we managed to secure one more catch of the FEC SD70M-2s, this time on train 222 northbound from Miami to Jacksonville with a stop at Fort Pierce. 105 and 142 were seen earlier, but we will take as many shots as we could get as their days are starting to get numbered. Very soon, General Electric ES-44C4s, as stated earlier, will be replacing these units in revenue service, and also will be displacing several FEC Champion SD-40-2s, which are to be leased to other railroads. We will keep you up to date as to how these locomotives get displaced in the coming months. Joining me on this mini vacation, and would like to salute all the veterans that have fought for and continue to fight for our country. From Hialeah, Florida, on the FEC main line, thanks for watching. Until next time, TE out.